happen, but according to all reports, the QB wants out of Houston. 9 NFL analysts were asked where Deshaun would play next season, and only one said Houston, while the Panthers and the Jets each got multiple votes. So, Shannon, how will this play out?
I still believe it was reaffirmed to me that Deshaun Watson wants out, and he's willing to do what it takes.
By the way, you've been ahead of this story from day one.
Yes, and a lot of people, you know, John McClain, and I know John, 45 years there, he said, the Texans don't want to trade him, but if they do, it's probably going to be to the Jets, which I've been saying all along. And I'm reading, listening to Adam Schefter talk about this young man resigning because he was also a part of, he was helping the search firm locate a general manager.
You mean the president who resigned?
Yes.
He's not young anymore. He used to be when he got
hired.
Been
20 years.
I mean, he was the original executive. He was hired 2 years before they started.
Right.
Okay.
And it was he was a part of helping the search firm.
Mm-hmm.
And they keyed in on two guys. Said, okay, these are the two guys. And then Cal McNair usurped everything and is like, nah, we're gonna go in a different direction. He said, well, then I'm out. Because now, and it reported that he stayed on because they didn't want to make it look like it was more dysfunctional than what it actually is. And when now you see just how much dysfunction is going on. Mm-hmm. Another reason why Deshaun doesn't want to be there. You see the dysfunctionality that's actually going on at the top. How can you win long-term, short-term, or anything when you have this kind of chaos going on within an organization? The trust has been broken. Now, you're probably going to be able to get a Matthew Stafford-type deal for Deshaun Watson.
I would hope so.
But I'm still saying Deshaun Watson will not play in Houston this season.
Mm. Okay. Let's step back from what is going to be the most fascinating, electrifying NFL offseason ever. Because
ever.
We got quarterbacks moving all directions.
Yes.
We got Matthew Stafford did an interview today that I just read, and he's talking about how I lost sight of the fact that he did demand the trade. Mm-hmm. And he said that conversation I had with the new Detroit executives and with the ownership was the hardest conversation I ever had in my life. I had to say, I want out.
Right.
Well, he got out.
Right. And remember, Skip, when they said it was mutual. And I say, normally that's the professional way of saying somebody wants out.
Okay.
We say we've agreed to mutually part ways.
Okay, so Jared Goff has moved, and it looks like Carson Wentz is on the precipice of moving any hour now.
Right.
And everywhere we look, Dak Prescott, is he going or staying? We're not sure. And
Russell Wilson put a little thing out there.
He did.
Aaron Rodgers.
All of a sudden, it's open season. Everybody is saying, you know what, maybe. And it all emanates from that guy down in Tampa Bay because they saw him say, okay, I'll go choose them and watch what I pull off Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody's saying, man, maybe I should change.
And plus, what did he do, Skip? Not only did he get there, his first year guy, he's like, hey, go get me Leonard Fournette. Okay. Go get me AB. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Go get me Gronk. Okay.
Thank you.
He said, hold on. Yeah. A guy just got there, and he got that kind of say, I've been here 10 years. I've been here 12 years. And y'all don't listen to the damn thing I say.
Okay. Which brings us back to Deshaun Watson.
Right.
A great young player.
He is.
He's proven a lot to me. Of the younger players, Brady's like in a universe by himself.
Right.
But he is the second best quarterback in football to Patrick Mahomes on just what I've seen so far in their resumes. Deshaun can win a Super Bowl.
Yes.
Yes. So he is a prized possession that might be on the open market, but we're not sure about that.
Right.
Okay, so what just happened? James Roots just said, I can't take it anymore.
Right.
The longest term employee, and remember, there was the woman who ran their communications division who was looked at as the best PR executive in pro football.
Right.
She got fired because she was a little too friendly with the media, and I believe she was the only who was running a media, you know, a communications division.
And I think either the equipment guy or the trainer got fired because they said he had a close relationship with Deshaun.
Okay, thank you very much. So now what do we know? The guy who's winning the power struggle is named Jack Easterby, and what did he used to be? For 6 years, he was
Chaplin, wasn't he?
The character coach. I don't know, maybe it was Colin Chaplin, but the character coach of Bill Belichick's Patriots.
Yes.
So he's a Belichick guy.
Yes.
Nick Caserio, who finally got hired despite what the search firm recommended, minority candidates, he was Belichick's right-hand man in New England.
Right.
Bill O'Brien, who's finally relieved of his duties of both coach and GM, was the offensive coordinator in New England. Mm-hmm. So somehow the McNair family is saying, give us the Patriot right. way. Give us the Patriot. Right. No. The Patriot way is Tampa Bay.
Right.
The Patriot way was Tom Brady.
Right.
It's not Nick Caserio.
You're right.
It's not Jack Easterby. It's not Bill O'Brien. He was a product of Tom Brady.
Right, right.
And the longer you try to go down that rabbit hole, the more lost you're going to get.
Well, I hope he's better because he's the offensive coordinator at Alabama now. So okay. So he'll do some great things
okay.
for Alabama.
Well, he might because he's going to have more talent than anybody else has. Right? Okay. So the one good thing that they did, this is just me, but again, he went to my school, played for my school, was David Culley. African-American, they hired him.
Right.
And he was Eric Bieniemy before Eric Bieniemy because right. he was, for years, Andy Reid's right-hand man.
Mm-hmm.
He was the assistant head coach right. to Andy Reid.
Right.
By all accounts, he's an NFL lifer.
Right.
He's a solid citizen. He's a good guy. He relates well to players. He has a little bit of a connection from last year's Pro Bowl to Deshaun. They did okay together. Like you say, it's just a Pro Bowl week, so right. you can't really take it to the bank.
Right.
But that was a good move to me, and it surprised me. But now we've got an organization who keeps publicly saying, we're sorry, we're just not going to trade him.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the one situation that so far the ownership is not caving to the quarterback
right.
who wants out.
Right.
And he wants out worse than anybody else has wanted yeah. out
yes.
to me.
Yes.
Like there's no doubt about this one.
Right.
This is the one where he says, I can't take it anymore.
Right.
I will hold out.
Right.
I assume that's what you're hearing, right?
Mm-hmm.
How long will he hold out? Would he hold out the year? Would they stay entrenched for a year just to prove their point and say, okay, we'll
do it? Yeah, Carson Wentz says, I'm not playing in Cincinnati anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Now you decide what you're going to do. I'm not playing. And they ended
Carson Palmer. Yeah.
And you remember what he did, Skip? They ended up trading him to the Raiders. I mean, take the stance, whatever that stance is, he wants to get out. Says, okay, well, y'all go play. Y'all do what y'all need to do. Eventually, they'll trade him.
Okay. Is it possible he's going to have to sit on ice for a year? Just
Might
out
have
of
to.
Spite?
Might have
just
to.
Because the blood's getting so bad
yep.
between those parties?
Yep. Because, you know, I'm sure Calvin there has some of his dad. He's not going to let the prisoners run the...
Well, that was the classic...
Yeah.
What, how was it the prisoners run the...
I can't have the inmates running the prison.
They're running the prison. There
it's
you go.
It's the inmates run the asylum.
Yeah, okay. There you go. Well, that was the classic. It was uttered inside closed doors
right.
to the other owners, but it got out.
And it got out, and that's one reason why Dwayne Brown is in Seattle blocking for Russell Wilson okay. instead of because he took offense to it.
He said no. Okay. So to me, it's going to be very interesting if this is the classic cut your nose off to spite your face.
Mm-hmm.
The McNair family would have history just to say, okay, We're just going to make you sit for a year, right?
Yeah, but I got $156 million. I'll sit it.
Well, he does.
I got it.
And they have him. They could control his rights. How many? Let's see.
They gave him 4 years.
They gave him four more. But
six
by
years.
Tag, you could go 6 years, right?
Well, Skip, they gave him. So they got the fifth-year option. They got the fifth-year option, and they got four more years. And then you got 2 years of tag. So theoretically, they could hold on to him until he's 33.
Okay. I'm not going to be surprised if this turns into the saddest story in pro football mm-hmm. where they just ice him for a year. They just say, okay,
right.
go home, sit,
right.
watch. We'll pay you, but we will not play you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Oh, I hope that's not the case. But, yeah, you mentioned this, Skip Shin. You have been all over this from the very beginning, so we'll have to wait and see how this one plays out. We know that the Bucs had a really good day yesterday celebrating, but have they gotten just a little too cocky already? Orlando Scandrick will join us. I would love his thoughts on the celebrations. Next. No mercy, no mercy.